So we all learn to count. We all learn to count forever, but nobody really learns that by literally counting forever. So there's got to be a eureka moment or tipping point when we figure out counting can go on and on. So what if I tell you the tipping point is exactly 73? Not too long ago, I realized learning to count is exactly the same thing as learning language. When learning a language, we have to learn the rules, we also have to learn the exceptions that go against the rules, just like learning regular verbs plus the irregular verbs. So over the years, I developed a theorem that tells exactly how many regular words a child would have to know to overcome the irregulars. So for English numbers, there are 17 exceptions that have to be rote memorized. 1 to 10, 11, not 10-1, not 1-teen, 12, 13, 15, 20, 30, and 50. So plugging 17 exceptions into this formula gives you 73. And believe me, that's right. So counting studies for children from the 1970s to 1980s have shown consistently when children, English learning children, can count to up to just over 70, they can go on to 100. In fact, it's very, very hard to find a child who stop at 85 and not all the way to 100. And this seems to work across languages. So for Chinese, which has a much simpler counting system, children can learn to count about a year ahead of American children. And French, for some of you know, has a more complex counting system. Even six-year-olds learning French cannot count to 100. So this study has two interesting implications for me. First, seems like language at the core of human cognition. And we figure out the concept there are infinitely many numbers by probably using the same mechanism that we learn languages. And so possibly without language, we can't even develop the concept of infinity or mathematics. Second, it seems very exciting that language and human mind works like a machine. You can study it precisely by formulating equations and by proving theorems. So to 73 and beyond. Thank you.